Good evening, this is Pastor Omar Muhammad coming to you live from my home here in Gardena, California. I was thinking about today and my subject, table talk. Mm-hmm. All right, girl, 1614, I'm glad you're here. Ali girl, I see, 1614, glad you're here. Miss Imani, I'm glad you joined. I'm here on my table talk with Pastor Omar, and I was thinking about Sandra Bland, and I was trying to figure out the full story, like what's really going on here. Why are we, good to see you, Crystal, God bless you, why are we experiencing so much trauma as a community and as a people? Today, I got a little sadness in my heart because today we buried my brother-in-law, who took his, he made his transition quickly. And that's been very interesting to me, just thinking about that. So yesterday I talked about choosing life, and today I'm thinking about all life matters. All human beings are important to God. All of us are in this wonderful journey. And one of the things I discovered on this Thanksgiving Day, on this Table Talk Tuesday, is that God specializes in uniquely crafting our situation in our life in such a way that He lets us know that He loves us unconditionally. He lets us know He loves us specifically. So I'm praying for the life of Sister Sandra Bland, that her death will be used to bring some serious thought to how we are treated, especially black women, black men in America. It's time for us to really take this stand and finish what Dr. Martin Luther King and others started. I know I get in trouble sometime when I start speaking this way. It doesn't sound like just from the scripture, but if our scripture does not have any practical application, then we are in trouble. We are all created in God's image and in God's likeness, so that any person, whether they have brown skin or light skin, who is mistreated, misused, abused, just snatched out of their car over a traffic ticket, it's a problem. Now, there's some other problems that are going on here. As I look a little bit deeper, a little bit closer, I'm wondering the same question. How does switching lanes with no signal turn into all of this? Part of it is we have to gain control as a people. We have to gain control over our situation. We have to recognize that part of the things that we have is with us. One thing I've learned, that death and life is in the power of the tongue. I've always believed that, and this is one of those kind of situations where it was like that. I don't know what those people did to my sister when she was in prison. It bothers me, it disturbs me, that they got her to a place that she wanted to, if it was suicide, I'm disturbed that they got her to a place of suicide. If they killed her, I'm disturbed that they killed her. I'm disturbed that she lost her life going to start a new job in Prairie View, Texas, and end up at the end of the day, a few days after that initial getting ready to start a job, dead in a prison cell. Now, I got a chance to see the video, and I hate seeing video. Well, let me just stop right here. This is Pastor Omar Muhammad. I am a proactive agent of change. Thank you for the love. I'm a proactive agent of change who communicates that others might be healed, liberated, and appreciated. Now, I know I'm about to say something controversial, especially in light of these situations. It's never right for anybody to take another person's life, whatever, for whatever color, whatever type of religion they have, whatever. It's not ours to do to take someone's life. That's not right ever. Whether we're taking them out of the womb for abortion, whether we're taking them off for taking them out ourselves in suicide, whether we're taking black men and women off the street and killing them, beating them up, and harassing them. Now, the other thing is, I always say keep your hands clean and your heart pure. Some of the things we have to do, we can do better. Now, if I'm going to get pulled over, I'm not going to say some crazy, wild, off the chain stuff to anybody. I'm just not going to do that because I know that I want to get home to my wife and children. I want to survive this particular situation. We have to teach one another how to survive. Death and life is in the power of the tongue. If we control our tongue, if we control what we say, we can speak life into a situation or we can speak death into a situation. Now, I'm convinced that we have to break the cycle of vengeance and violence. We have to break the cycle of this constant deception of what that's going on in our life. There's a constant deception. We're constantly being forced to look at ourselves as some kind of fleshly being. Look at yourself as a black person. Look at yourself as a woman. Look at yourself as this. That's not what God have us. God would have us look at ourselves as children of the living God. See ourselves as He sees us, whole, complete, pure, perfect, right, straight. I mean, he just sees us in such a wonderful way. He said he gave all that he had, he gave the best that he had, that we might have life, and that we might have life more abundantly. So I'm encouraging us to do this. I'm encouraging us to stop focusing on all this small time stuff. Yes, we're going to have to do some very serious work in terms of making sure that people respect us, not look at us, respect us for the content of our character rather than by the color of our skin. For sure, like Dr. Martin Luther King said, we are in times, it seems like, that our times presently are worse than the times that Dr. King was talking about. So we're going to have to support and encourage our prophetic leaders to speak up and to say whatever they're going to say and to do what we're going to do. Now, I'm a younger, older guy, so I'm going to do my part. I'm going to put words out. I'm going to encourage my young lions who are training up under me and the mentorship to use this scripture. Good to see you, DM Francois. I want you to work with me, roll with me. I want you to know that this is Pastor Omar Muhammad. I'm a proactive agent of change. And I want to say this. We're going to have to do better than just allowing people to misuse us or abuse us because we say something crazy out of our mouths. We have to control our tongue. James taught us that the tongue sets a world of fire. I mean, it's like, you know, you can move a whole lot of things with a little small rudder, but a tongue can set a whole world on fire. This situation with my sister, Sister Sandra Bland, I want you to lift this up. But this situation with my sister was exacerbated by her tongue and the officer's tongue. The officer had an ego situation where he was just mad that this sister was just telling him off. You know how we are, sisters. You know how we are. I'm married to a black woman. I love black women, but you know what our sisters can do it with the tongue. We can lash a person down with our tongue. Now, but we should also, what we can also do, we can bless a person. We can speak words of life into our children. We can speak words of encouragement into our husband. We can speak words of life into humanity, and people will just rise up to the occasion. And I'm encouraging us to begin to not get in a situation where we bring our own demise on us by the things that we say out of our mouth. Let us be wise stewards of our tongue. Let us be wise stewards of our word. We have to realize that we create image. Thank you for the love. We create images and thoughts and mindsets. So what we say out of our mouth actually said the word. What does the Bible say? The word became flesh and dwelt among us. What? The word. And he said, let there be light, and there was light. This is all just from what we're saying. So what we're saying is creating a world and creating an environment. So we want to create an environment that brings life. We want to create an environment that brings health. We want to create an environment that brings healing and deliverance and wholeness. This is what we want to do, and we can do that out of our mouth. We can think. We can take time to meditate, to think, ask God, what should I say? Show me how to use my mouth. What should I say? In fact, I would not even come onto this broadcast tonight until I sat down and said, God, give me something to say. God, give me a word for my people. Don't let me go on to Periscope broadcast and say something that does not make sense at all. That's just out of order. We want to say something that's going to encourage people. What did I say my name is? My name is Pastor Omar Muhammad. I am a proactive agent of change who communicates that others might be healed, liberated, and appreciated. I'm hoping that somebody might get this replay and say, you know what? I'm going to listen to what Pastor Omar said. I'm not going to just start a situation with my words. I'm not going to start up with words and say things that cause a fight, that cause a destruction, that cause me to get myself arrested over something. I could have probably got out with a ticket and said, okay, but no. That did not happen in this situation. And I'm sorry that didn't happen. And I do not like what happened to my sister Sandra Bland. If you don't know her, today we had a conversation in my car. And I asked my children, do y'all know who Sandra Bland is? And somebody said, well, you know what? They don't know who he is. It's a child. But you know what? My son rose up and said, no, I know exactly who Sandra Bland is. Sandra Bland is that sister who got killed in Texas over a traffic incident. And I was proud of him because he's absolutely aware. 14 years old, he's aware. But you know what that means? That means he's also aware that there are forces in this world who look at his body, who look at him and say, he's a monster, he's a beast, he's not worth living. And we have to be able to teach our children how to survive being pulled over by the cops. What to say, what to do in those kind of situations so that they can come home to us. Oh, the likelihood that they might get pulled over is very real. But the likelihood that they can survive it is up to them. Let us figure out a way that we can teach our children how to survive. My thing is, keep your hands clean and your heart pure. What you're thinking in your head, think good and righteous and godly thoughts. What you're doing out there in your actions, do good deeds. God bless the soul of Sister Sandra Bland. And may God bless the soul of Michael Largins. I know that God loves everyone, and He loves us so individually so that He can bless you. Like, are you tuned into this broadcast today? Because God wanted you to hear this word. He loves you, and He will do everything He can to reconcile you, to make sure that you understand that He wants to live fully in you. He created you to be a great, powerful human being. He created you with the same kind of powers that He has. What? Let there be light, and there was light. We think a thought, we create it in our mind. Next thing you know, the thing that we thought, the thing that we speak, the thing that we think about actually comes into existence. So we want to be very mindful of the things that we say that come out of our mouth. We will not speak death over our community. We won't say black people can't get together, because they can. We will say black people will get together. We will say this world will get better. And I'm going to do it every day, day by day. I'm going to speak words of life and healing and hope to our community and to ourselves. We need to look at ourselves in the mirror and say, you are a beautiful human being. You're created in God's image, in God's likeness. You can do great and mighty things. You can accomplish what you will. Rise up and accomplish that goal, that destiny that God has for you. You are here on purpose. You are here on assignment. Not to waste your time with a whole bunch of watching TV and a whole bunch of false reality TV. That's not what God will have you to do. God will have you. Thank you for the love. God will have you use your time wisely to figure out what you can do. The things that you are concerned about, the things that get on your nerve, the things that bother you, that is a direction in the right direction so you understand what your passion is. I'm sick and tired of people misusing other people by just because of the color of their skin. So I'm using my medium. I'm using Periscope to say, remember Sandra Bland, but also remember that you are created in God's image and His likeness. He wants to use you to send forth love and healing and devotion in this world. So I'm using my mediums. You use yours. Use your gifts. Use your talents to reach somebody today. This is Pastor Omar. I'm going to get on out of here, but I want you to do this for me today. Would you lift up Sandra Bland? Would you lift up Michael Largins? You don't know him, but he's made a sudden transition. Would you choose life no matter what's going on in the situation? Would you speak words of life today? Would you speak the world that you want to see come into existence tonight? When you go to bed, give God thanks for everything. I'm thanking them because I got a call. Come on over here, sir. We want to invite you to a prayer breakfast with some pastors. There were just a few pastors in there. But do you know the man of God spoke a word of God over me and my wife that was so specific, so right on time, I realized that God loves me. God loves you that way too. He will work all of creation to make sure you get the word that you need, to make sure you get the healing that you need. You tune into this broadcast today because God loves you that much to give you a specific word. You know what to do with this word. Go forth and multiply. Make disciples of who? Of Christ in you. Because what God wants to do, what I discovered today, what God wants to do, He wants to so fill you up with so much of Him that wherever you go, wherever you touch, you represent Him everywhere you go. And I want you to represent the Most High in a wonderful way. Let the world know that God is not dead. Oh, they did not kill Him in philosophy. They did not kill Him in religion. He is still alive, and He wants to relate to you and me. God bless you for all that love right now. God bless you. This is Pastor Omar Muhammad. I'm going to get out of here. Keep your hands clean and your hearts pure. I love you, and there's nothing you can do about it but share that love with someone else. Share this broadcast with other friends and let them know that God has not forgotten them. God bless you, and God rest the soul of Sister Sandra Bland. God bless you. Bye-bye.